the millions of tons of material intended for recycling may end up just being dumped.
Tonight, consumer investigator Steve Spraysia is digging deeper into the changing recycling market.
Do this. You assume that a lot of the stuff that you throw away is going to be recycled. But wait a minute. Turns out a lot of the stuff that we try to recycle can't be reused because, quite simply, the marketplace is changing or there are now restrictions on what we can export.
Turns out a lot of what we recycle should never have gone into the bin in the first place. And places like Shimar Recycling have to sort it all out before it gets sold for reuse.
Coffee cup,
lid, paper cup, plastic cup, plastic bags.
Landfill.
And then there's stuff like paper, which used to be profitable but no longer.
Mixed paper, for instance, has gone from, somewhere from $85 to $100 a ton last year to down to nothing.
Add to that China's so-called green fence, which now keeps out tons more plastic, paper, and metal, and you can see why recyclers are in a pinch.
Where does that stuff end?
Well, unfortunately, it's no longer recyclable. There's not a market for it. It'll go to the landfill.
China used to take an estimated 16 million tons of recyclables before their ban. Now, with fewer places to sell it, it's just piling up.
Things are being warehoused, I am certain of that, in order to try to prevent those things having to ever be landfilled, trying to wait for markets to recover domestically.
In the meantime, people recycle more and more stuff, creating a tsunami of waste with fewer outlets available to reuse it.
Though China's green fence may be making it tougher for recyclers right now, the upside is that eventually it could help this country develop a lot of new domestic markets for recycling. For the CBS 17 investigators, I'm Steve Spraysia.
Every year, 7 million...